talk with Mo Casera, and we were just talking about how the president comes to Mo's building, so Mo gets to come down to the D.C. area. They got the presidential debate between President Obama and Governor Mitt Romney tonight. Is that causing a little bit of a stir on campus, and well, does it put you out at all?
It certainly put us out. We haven't been in our offices for quite some time now. The Secret Service took over our building, our practice facility, our locker rooms, and everything, so we've been kind of on the other side of campus. I did get a chance to walk over to that side of campus yesterday, and I'll tell you, it's really buzzing. It's the world media is there, you know, today, so it's pretty exciting.
Well, that's great, and it's pretty exciting what you've got going on this year. I know that as you've got, you know, so many different blends of talents that you're trying to work together this year. You've got a couple very intriguing transfers that come in. Talk to us about those two newcomers in particular.
Well, we've got two transfers who sat out last year. One of them, Jamal Coombs McDaniel, who transferred from UConn, who was on the national championship team, and has had a lot of experience and been very successful. Won a Big East championship, won a national championship, played in the Final Four. And Teron Bowie, transferred from Penn State, a very highly recruited Big Ten recruit. Those two guys sat out last year. We're expecting some big things from them. And I use the word transition a lot. I think they're going to help us transition through the post-Charles Jenkins era, if you will. And now we also have a group of five brand-new freshmen as well. So I think they're going to help us bridge that gap.
Well, you know, you have a couple guys back I thought really played well for you last year. Mejia did a good job at the point. And, of course, Iams got hurt. I think it hurt your team late in the year. But are they both back and healthy to get ready to go?
They are. I think one of the real challenges last year, we had a tough year. But, you know, we lost a lot of close games. Mejia was in and out of the lineup with injuries all year. Iams missed the whole end of the season last year. Those guys are both healthy. They've lost some weight. We've really worked on their bodies in the offseason. So I'm excited about, you know, their veteran leadership, and I think they're going to provide us a lot this year.
Mo, when you talk about two players in Coombs McDaniel and Bowie who transferred, who got to work with you guys but really didn't get to play any basketball, what's the legitimate expectation on how quickly they get back to competitive basketball timing and skill set?
That's the real challenge, I think, when you have transfers, you know. And I also think you throw in a whole group of new freshmen there. So we have so many new faces and so many kind of new moving parts. It's going to take a little time to get the dust off. I'm adamant with our staff all the time about being patient. You know, we're going to have to learn and move and juggle a little bit early on. But I think once they get their legs back underneath them, I hope as the CAA season kind of rolls around after the holidays, we can be pretty competitive.
So does it help then, you know, the type of pre-conference schedule that you play? Are you going to kind of get to do different things, maybe experiment a little bit on to see and get ready for the conference?
Yeah, game? I think we'll have to. I think we'll have to play some different lineups. I think we'll have to throw a bunch of different guys in there and certainly get some experience. And I think that's what it really takes, you know. But we've got a lot of young energy, a lot of excitement, a lot of youth, and some depth now. You know, one thing we didn't have last year with all these guys sitting out and some injuries, we really, you know, struggled down the stretch because we had no depth.
How long do you feel it takes to put these guys together and develop some type of chemistry with your team, understanding what you and your staff want from them?
You know, I don't know if there's an exact timetable. Right. As you know, sometimes teams come together quicker than you think they
right.
will. I'm hopeful that they will. I think, as we already mentioned, we have some good senior leadership. So I'm hoping that it comes a little quicker than later. You know, we obviously want to be playing good basketball in the middle of the winter, and we have to try to get to the point where we're playing good basketball heading into the CAA tournament.
As we were talking with Ron Hunter of Georgia State earlier and talked about all the players from Georgia and the Atlanta area on his roster, you've got 9 players on your roster from New York, 8 of them from the New York area. How critical is that for you to get some of that great New York City area talent?
That's where we have to butter our bread, no question about it. You know, really in that New York tri-state area, we've been able to do that. We're creeping into New Jersey a little bit as well, and there's certainly a lot of talent there, and we have to keep working to keep those guys home and keep them at Hofstra.
One of the new rules that the last few years is that you've been able to work with these guys in the summer and out of season a lot more than we used to do. If we walk through the gym, we used to get in trouble back then. But how has this helped you, or what is your opinion of this new rule, and has it helped the team develop a lot quicker?
You know, that's a great question. I think it kind of a follow-up to your earlier question. I think that being able to work with some of these young guys throughout the summer and certainly through a little bit more through the fall and while they're there in summer school, I think really helps us. It's going to help our progress. You know, it's going to speed us up a little bit. And I think it's a good thing. You know, I think sometimes people think, hey, it makes the season too long. It's almost a year-round thing. But I think for some of those kids that we had this year, I think it's going to help their progress.
Mo, entering your third season at Hofstra in the CAA, How do you look at this this season in the conference kind of shaking out?
Boy, I tell you, I look up and down that that preseason poll, and there's no easy games there. You know, I mean, I look at the top, and there's some teams that I think are as good as any mid-major teams that are probably in the country. And I look down, you know, on the quote-unquote the bottom, and I think there's a lot of really improved teams down there. And there's some really good coaches, as you guys know. So I don't think there's an easy game in this league, and that's what makes it so great.
That is the fun part, as we see the CAA preseason men's basketball rankings. We've got Hofstra right now at 7, but always ready to pull a few surprises. And you're right, that group in front of you has certainly got a little bit of a talent that you could certainly make a run at, though, right?
Yeah, I agree. You know, I think there's a lot of new faces in the league. We lost a lot of talent last year. And, hey, you know, anything can happen if you're playing good basketball in February and early March.
Good. Mo, thanks so much. Good seeing you.
Thanks, guys. Always great to see you. Thanks.
Mo Casera, the head basketball coach for the men at Hofstra University.